Today I'm excited to show you my latest 3D printable project, Lab Rax, a fully modular and customizable 10-inch rack system for your home lab setups. Whether you're running Raspberry Pis, mini PCs, or networking gear, this rack is designed to keep things organized, be customizable to your needs, and look great on your desk. So what makes Lab Rax special? First and foremost, it's designed to be entirely 3D printable, apart from a few fasteners and brass inserts holding it together. I've also designed it in a way that makes it printable on common bed sizes around 250mm square, so you don't need a large printer or an XL build plate to print it out. It also needs minimal support material. In fact, the only supports required are four of these thin strips, so there's very little filament waste and hardly any post-processing required. Next is that it's fully modular. The side panels and posts are available in increments from 1U to 5U, because 5U is the largest you're able to print on a 250mm bed. But you can join two of these together to make any combination of units up to 10U. You can technically add another joint and make it larger than 10U, but at this point, the strength of the 3D printed parts starts to become an issue if the rack is full of equipment. The last is the cost. These 10-inch mini racks typically cost between $80 and $150 for the bare shell ranging from 4 units to 12 units. This 5U rack uses 580 grams of filament for the frame and another 360 grams for the side panels, if you choose to print those, so it can be printed from a single 1 kg spool of filament. This costs as little as $15 for a refill roll of PETG from Bamboo Lab. Couple that with $3 worth of brass inserts and $3 worth of M6 button head screws for the frame, and the total cost for this complete bare 5U rack is around $21, which is almost a quarter of the cost of the commercial version. Today's video is sponsored by FlexiSpot and their E7 Pro standing desk. If you're like me and spend a lot of time at your desk, whether it's editing videos, tinkering with hardware, or just getting work done, having the option to stand has made a big difference in my workflow. I can still sit down when I'm spending longer periods at my desk, but if I need to quickly move back and forth between my desk and other work surfaces in my workshop, or just stretch my legs, then having the option to stand is great. This desk is built solid. It has dual motors that make height adjustments through its 65cm range really fast, and it can lift up to 200kg. So it's got no problem dealing with my 50kg laser cutter or my 30kg Carvera Air. The programmable control panel lets you set up four preferred heights, and these are all reachable with a single tap, so you can switch positions in a few seconds, and it goes to the same position every time. It's also got a child lock function, and even has a USB port on the side for charging a mobile device. The E7 Pro comes with a few customization options, like different desktop sizes and finishes, different leg colors, and some add-ons to suit your workflow and to keep your work area organized. So if you're looking for a good quality standing desk that's built to last, I'd recommend having a look at FlexiSpot's E7 Pro. It comes with a 10-year warranty, and I'll leave a link to it in the video description. Now back to my 10-inch rack. As far as dimensions go, there isn't a well-defined standard for 10-inch racks, but I've gone with the most commonly accepted dimensions. It uses the same 44.45mm rack unit spacing as the larger 19-inch racks. The holes are 236.525mm apart, and there's 222mm of usable width between the posts, so it should be compatible with most commercially available 10-inch hardware. I've gone with M6 screws instead of 1032 screws, because M6 screws are much easier to find in Australia, Asia, and Europe, and I've designed lab racks to use the same M6x10mm screws to secure the rack and to assemble the frame itself, so you don't need to buy a bunch of different screw sizes. 1032 screws can be used interchangeably to secure the racks if you don't use the brass inserts. If there's enough interest, I'll release a second version of the rack with joints that use 1032 screws entirely too. Now here's where things get fun. The Lab Rax design is very easily customizable. Being 3D printed, there are a lot of colors available to print the frame out in. I've used PETG for mine, as it's a bit more durable and heat resistant than PLA. But if you're using components that don't generate a lot of heat, like a couple of pies and a small switch, then PLA will work fine too. Apart from the frame components, the sides, top and bottom panels can either be 3D printed to match or contrast the frame, or they can be laser cut from 3mm acrylic or 3mm plywood. So this allows you to add clear or tinted panels, or even add a walnut or birch accent to your build. Bamboo Lab recently sent me their A1 combo to try out. so I've used that to print out all of the components used for both of my racks. The A1 has a bed size of 256 by 256 millimeters, which fits the 5U rack frame across 10 plates, and has a total print time of 26 hours. To start out, we've got the four vertical posts on one bed. This is the set of 5U posts as my initial build. Then we need a set of the four edge pieces, along with two handles and four feet. The feet can also be printed separately in TPU. This will give it a softer base and a bit of vibration dampening if you're running fans or hard drives in your rack. The top and bottom horizontal pieces are a bit too long to fit across the bed, but they do fit in diagonally. Because of this, only one fits onto the bed at a time, but they print out quite quickly, each taking about 1.5 hours. With the AMS light that allows multicolor or multi-material printing on the A1, you can add even more customization to your parts. I quite like using a different color for a few layers on the ventilation or fan covers, and it's useful for adding text into the print to label devices. I've also used it to add lab racks to the top edge. I printed out a set of side panels along with the top and bottom panels on my original rack to demonstrate how they fit in. But I really like the look of tinted or clear acrylic panels, so I've laser cut a set of these from 3mm tinted acrylic for my second rack. As I mentioned previously, the rack assembles with M6 by 10mm screws and some M6 brass inserts. Each of the four posts and four edge pieces need two brass inserts, which are melted into place using a soldering iron. There are also brass inserts in the top and bottom to mount the handles and feet onto. There's an option of either using nuts on the back of the M6 screws to secure the racks, or you can add brass inserts to the vertical posts so that they can be tightened from the front, sort of like a captive nut used on a 19-inch rack. I made up my first two used nuts, and I'll make up this one using brass inserts. With those melted into place, we can start assembling the base. Two of the side edge pieces and two horizontal pieces are assembled around a 3D printed or acrylic base panel. I've used solid horizontal pieces around the base, and I'll use vented ones at the top. They are interchangeable, so you can use any combination you'd prefer. We can then add the four vertical posts. Then slide the two 3D printed or acrylic side panels into place, then add the top two horizontal pieces. We can then add the top panel and close it up with the last two edge pieces. To finish it off, we can add the two handles to the top and the four feet to the bottom. These also use the same hole pattern, so you can put handles on the bottom as a stand if you'd like to, or feet on the top of the rack to stack two racks together. And that's the basic rack complete. As I mentioned earlier, you can configure the rack to any number of rack units from 1 to 10, and reuse most of the parts. The only parts that need to be swapped out or added to are the four vertical posts and the two side panels. If we reprint these as smaller sections, we can make up a 3U rack, and if we combine them with the 5U posts using these joiners, then we can make up an 8U rack. If you aren't using two of the same length posts, then it's a good idea to put the side panels in the opposite way around so the joints don't line up. This gives it a bit more rigidity. To populate the rack, I've designed a few commonly used panels that can be 3D printed as a starting point. I've made a series of blank plates and ventilation plates to cover up open units or to be modified to fit custom equipment. I've got two fan options to provide cooling. This one fits 5 40mm fans, and another 2-unit one fits 2 80mm fans. Then I've designed a series of shelves to mount switches, UPSs, mini PCs, and other networking equipment onto. For my rack, I've adapted the shelves to hold a 6-port QNAP switch with 10GB and 2.5GB ports, another for a 5-port TP-Link switch with 2.5GB ports, and one to hold my compact NAS. I've also designed two patch panels, a half-U Keystone 12-port patch panel, and a 1U D-Type patch panel. I haven't forgotten about my Raspberry Pis. I've designed a 1U panel to mount 3 Raspberry Pi 5s onto, and a 2U panel to mount 7 Pis or a combination of other SBCs on pull-out trays. So that's an overview of my LabRax project, a modular, fully 3D printable home lab solution that you can customize to fit your needs. If you're interested in building one yourself, I've put all of the LabRax system components and the racks and trays shown in this video up on MakerWorld. If you've got a Bamboo Lab A1, P1S or X1C, then you can use the pre-configured print profiles I've uploaded and print the components directly from the Bamboo Handy app on your phone. I'm also keen to take on your feedback to make improvements to the LabRax system, so let me know in the comments section if there are any obvious features missing that you'd like to see added, or if you're interested in seeing a 1032 screw size version. If you do build your own, tag me on social media or leave a comment on MakerWorld or on my blog. I'd love to see your creations and additions. Thanks for watching. Please remember to like this video if you enjoyed it and subscribe for more tech and electronics projects, tutorials, and reviews.